The DCIS score can be very helpful in individualized cases. Let's look at an example. Mike, share with us an example of how the DCIS score has been really helpful to you.
Sure. I can think of one patient specifically, a postmenopausal woman, 56 years old, just under 2 centimeters of DCIS intermediate grade, had a lumpectomy, margins a little over 2 millimeters clear, ER positive DCIS with no other risk factors. So classically speaking, as you know, most radiation oncologists would quote this patient about a 25 to 30% risk of local recurrence with lumpectomy alone. Adding the radiation for 5-6 weeks could drop that down to maybe 10%. We ordered the DCIS score and her score came back showing that her risk of a local recurrence was actually about 14%, about 12 to 14% at 10 years without radiation. Even more specifically, her risk of an invasive cancer recurrence was only 6% at 10 years, and that's without radiation. I think what's really important about that is that we can now compare that to a woman that has something like atypical ductal hyperplasia. If the same woman had atypical ductal hyperplasia on her biopsy with all of her risk factors, and if you utilize something like the Gale model to look at her risk, she has about a 3% risk of an invasive cancer at 5 years or a 6% risk of invasive cancer at 10 years. We'd never radiate that patient. Why would we radiate the DCIS patient with the same risk?
I think that's a really great example of how the DCIS score is helpful for the individual case.